The NFL wanted to draft me, but I turned them down. I mean, I don't need the hassle. I don't need the headache. Trooper, second floor, I hear you. All right, I got a very time-sensitive Go Gamble blend drop to do. I have the boosted board with me, but because of where I gotta go, I think I'm probably gonna be faster without it. Now I think I'm crazy. I think the boosted board would have been faster. But there comes a point where it's definitely slower to go back and get the board. I think I've hit that point. Yeah, this is crazy, but maybe we won't have to wait. Is that a tram that's here right now? If it is, I mean, I'm not gonna be able to make it, right? Am I gonna have to wait for a tram? Is my timing just completely effed up today? The answer to the question is yes. My timing is completely effed up today. If I had just run a little tiny bit faster, we would have made that tram. The shiny horse is gone. Where's the shiny horse's ass? All right, so it's Aria today in the, what do you call it? Troopers 2022 Guide to Las Vegas Poker Rooms. Today, Aria. What volume is this? I've lost track. Is this volume number 5? I don't know, look at the title. So I saw something on Twitter. I avoided this area. That's why I didn't park closer to where I was going. Plus, I wasn't 100% sure the exact location where I was going for the Go Gamble blend drop. But I think there's some construction action going out here because of the NFL draft. I think the NFL draft is going to be, I don't know. Listen, this is all hearsay. This comes from Twitter through Lady Trooper into my ear. But I think the draft is going to be over the fountains. Is it gonna be on top of the fountains? I guess that's possible. But I see a bunch of cops down there. What's going on? I mean, I don't see construction. I see cops. Oh, I do see a crane now. All I know is someone on Twitter said something about the shit show that will be the NFL draft being here in Vegas on the Strip and how traffic will probably be a cluster, you know what. So they referenced that with a picture of shit going on in front of the fountains. Who knows if it's even related. The draft isn't for like 2 weeks or something like that. I know I just said I would be playing at Aria. Trooper, what the hell are you doing all the way in front of Bellagio? Well, I had to make the coffee drop, and now I'm curious as to what's going on down there in front of the fountains. I got to get some food. There's 2 sparkly pop drops I got to make at some point, but definitely got to get back to Aria. We got to talk about Aria in the poker room guide. You got taxi drivers with wild Charlie Manson hair blowing the horn. I wonder how long I would have to stand here before I see someone get creamed by a car for walking when it says don't walk. As soon as one person walks, the entire herd, here we go. Maybe we'll get one right now. Get 100 points for each one. No? This is not the town to jaywalk, I'm telling you. are beginning construction on what will be some kind of like place where they're going to stage the NFL draft. Is it going to be over the water, over the fountain? I don't know. Is it going to be like up here? I don't know. Who knows? It's going to be around here somewhere, though. I don't know if you know this, but not only can I drive a forklift, I'm pretty damn good at it. In fact, I generally like to push my shopping cart at the grocery store forklift style. If you know how a forklift works, you know what I'm talking about. Speaking of food, I saw evidence on Twitter of a new Dirt Dog location. The little food court near M&M's World down there, from what I gather. I saw a little sign. So the obvious choice for food when I'm playing at Aria is Posh Burger. Posh Burger is pretty tasty, and it's right next door to the poker room. I parked at Park MGM. I'm gonna play poker at Aria, and I am currently standing right over BFFB, BFF Bucks, which means my favorite Starbucks on the strip. I really want a nice coffee from there. I almost went to Hattie B's so that I could get the, I don't want a coffee before I get food. That doesn't make any sense. I mean, I can have coffee anytime, don't get me wrong, but I'm gonna want one after.
Especially when they have a tiny bus, how about you?
So I don't want to call the guy crazy, because I'm not sure that he's crazy, but that guy is chanting, "We like Filipinos, we like Japanese too, we like Asian girls as long as they got small butts," or something like that. I don't know what he's talking about. Being that it is only 3:15 in the PM, I think I will have two choices for Starbucks after Posh Burger. The one right here in Crystal's Mall is open, and I'm pretty sure the one upstairs at Aria will be open at that point. You know, I don't know if I have any comps at Aria. As I make my final approach on the Aria poker room, I will inform you that Aria has kind of a large poker room. The max rake is $5. They do have time rake games. I believe that 5-10 and above are time drop. I can also tell you that they do not have poker promotions at Aria. I know what you might be thinking, a few of you, how can that be? How can there be no promotions? Well, here's the promotion at Aria. Every time you win a pot, you win an extra $2 in that pot. That's your promotion. Unlike the poker rooms with promotions, they do not take a promotional drop out of the pots. So if you play a $50 pot at MGM Grand, they're taking $5 for the rake, $2 for the promo fund. Here, if you play a $50 pot, they're taking $5 for the rake, and that's it. So they're not taking extra money out of the pots. More money stays on the table, more money stays in the game, more money goes into your pocket. And by the way, when I say $50, I'm referring to a 1-3 game or a 1-2 game. 2-5. They rake it at higher increments. I think it's got to be $100 before they take out that fifth dollar. The Aria poker room is 24/7, and they do have daily tournaments here every day at 1 p.m. Sunday through Thursday, I think the buy-in is $140. Friday and Saturday, it's $240. They also usually have PLO. I can tell you that today, right now, there are 5-1-3 games, 3-2-5 games, 2-5-5 PLO with a rock, and 1-1-2 PLO, and there's a 6-12 mixed game, and it says that there's a 5-100 PLO. What does that mean? 5-100 PLO. I don't know what the hell that means. They got PLO action going, that's all I know. Every time I have had the fries at Poshburger, they have been extremely good. They're just like perfect fries. Perfect for some reason. I don't know why. I don't know how they do it, but they're great. That's why I don't order them when I order a double, because I eat every single one. And this time is no exception. I ate every single one. Every single freaking fry and every bite of that burger. By the way, I did have $14 in comps. You get $2 an hour in comps here. I was corrected the other day that MGM, apparently you only get $1 in comps there. Someone told me, El Diesel actually, Rice is a Spoon Food, told me that they only give you a dollar. The dealer at the table told me two. I don't know if the guy's new, I don't know if maybe, I don't know. But here at Aria, it is $2 an hour, so it adds up. You can get a nice double cheeseburger from Poshburger after just 7.5 hours of poker. Aria does indeed have a parking garage. Yes, they do charge for parking. If you are Pearl, or if you are local, you get 3 hours, I think it is, for free. If you're Pearl, you park for free. Incidentally, I did not park here at Aria. I parked at Park MGM. Same company, same card, free parking for Pearl. Correct me if I'm wrong here, but I'm thinking Starbucks and then poker. Yeah? This used to be the buffet. It was just sitting empty for a long time. Now they got walls around it. I guess they're gonna do something there. Who knows? On the strip where you might find higher stakes games, and that would be Aria and Bellagio. I want to say Encore, you know, Wynn. I don't know if they ever have any higher stakes games though. I mean, maybe they do and I just don't pay attention. Currently the highest game, at least listed on Bravo, is a 5,100 PLO game at Aria tonight. Aria Poker Room is kind of on the classier side. I mean, not really, but I mean, it's a large room. They take the room seriously as far as like staff, except tonight. I have to say that there were quite a few dealers who were frustrating me. Put it that way. Let's just put it that way. I mean, you really should be able to follow the action as a dealer. If you can't follow the action, then you really, I mean, occasionally it's because you just don't care to follow the action, but there are some dealers who just can't seem to follow the action. One of the most important things to pay attention to as you spread the flop onto the table is the first player to act. You should make sure that that player checks or bets before you start pulling the rake or whatever else you might be doing. That's actually one of the places where dealers hang up a lot, that they don't make sure that the flop action begins before they start paying attention to other things. Because there's nothing worse in the world that I check, like, I don't pinky check, a good 3 raps on the table, and then the dealer looks at me and waits for me to act. It's like, come on, man. So there are good poker sessions and there are bad poker sessions. And no matter how good or bad you may be at the game, if you continue to play poker, you will have good sessions and bad sessions. You will also have exceptionally good sessions as well as exceptionally bad sessions. Tonight, for me, was about as bad as it gets. Nothing held up. The river was treacherous. I end up losing $11.49. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.